Yes, hello everyone. Thanks for coming to this session. It's about Android Wear, as you can see. I want to say thanks about this event to Bulgarian Jack community and the jPrime conference team. It's a very great event, so I'm very happy to be here. First of all, who am I? I'm co-founder and CEO of apps. It's written like 4PPS. We call it apps. I develop Android and iOS for, I think, 5 months. I'm developing only iOS, but I love Android still. I'm a member of GDG Ankara. GDG is Google Developer Groups. It's a group that they are groups that Google supports them. So we make some events like this, the bigger ones, the smaller ones. We always make events. And I'm an Android evangelist. So I want to talk about ADD. Android Developer Days, which is held in Ankara a few weeks ago. The final photograph of the event. It was very crowded. There were over 2,500 people there. So let's start with wearables. Android Wear is not this. This is a funny joke about Apple, but Android Wear is not this. Android Wear is not this also. Glass is different from Android Wear. This uses glassware. Android Wear uses an Android operating system special for wearable devices. There are some Android Wear devices. Here is the Motorola's one. The Intel's one. It's very fashionable design, bracelet. And this is the LG's one. There are two types of wearables, rounds and rectangles. So wearables are everywhere, as you can see. I can exactly say that brace yourselves. We will see wearable everywhere. So we started to see it everywhere. In which fields we can use it? Activity tracking, for example, running, exercising, and heart monitoring for us. We can use it for messaging apps. For example, WhatsApp. If you have a wearable device, you can use WhatsApp. I want to ask something. Anybody got Android Wear device in there? I think one. Cool. I don't have any yet. So let's go on. With wearable devices, also with Android Wear, your phone's battery will last longer. You may ask, how can it be possible? You don't have to check your phone in every notification sound. There are several messages, several notifications our phone gets in day. But with Wear, you just check it on your watch, and you can dismiss it, or maybe it's if it is important, you can reply or make some actions with it. So you don't have to open your phone. This makes your battery last longer. Now let's look about how can we make our existing apps Android Wear compatible. The easiest one is here, notifications. Everybody knows notifications. They are cool features. You can send the phone or the tablet some notifications with sounds. Maybe some actions. So this is the easiest one with wearable. Here you see an example. This is Hangouts screen. Hangouts notifications. The left one is a notification which is seen on the handset device. The right one is on the wearable device, Android Wear device. As you can see, the Wear one is very simple, just showing the message. And if you swipe left or right, you can see the actions buttons here. The trick is here. If you send notifications to your handheld device, as usual you do, the notification will be seen on the Android Wear device as well. But you have to use notification compat class to show it on wearable device. In handset, we use notification class to make notifications and show notifications on phone. If you use notification compat class instead of the notification class, the notification will appear on Android Wear 2. Here's an example with code. I will write the code on my computer, leave here. So just let's look at it. We create two pending intents to make actions with them. The first one opens the main activity. The second one opens the dialer app. These are two pending intents. If you want more action, for example, reply, delete, mark as read, etc., you can create some other pending intents too. Here we create an action for the pending intents that we created. Here, as you can see, we use notification compat class, not notification class. We create an action. We give it an image, a text, and pending intent. So that's the real code block that creates the notification. Again, you can see we use notification compat class. We set its icon, title, text, with this builder. We can set content intent, which is when we click on the directly on the notification, this pending intent will run. Then some other options too. Then with this line, the notify method, we can show the notification on the phone and on the Wear 2. Here is something different from the notification class. The extend method. We use this for some actions that we don't want to appear on the handheld device. So here the action we created previous, we created on the previous slide. Sorry. Yes, here is. We use this action in there. This means that the action, this action, should only shown in Android Wear device, not on the phone or the tablet. So this action, maybe we can call it a button for notification, will not appear on the phone or on tablet. It just will appear on wearable device. So here is the result. It's Hangouts app. As you can see, there is some notification in here. And if you swipe it to left, you can see the reply button. If you click it, the pending intent that you set for this will run. This is a good picture, I think. I like it very much. Here is the notification. They are same notifications. Here is the notification that's shown on the handset device. A long text, a picture, a title, two buttons, and lots of informations on there. But in Wear, in our watches, we don't have so much, that much space, so we have to keep it simple. So we show the, actually Android Wear shows the message like this, your icon, your title, and the text. If you swipe it, you can reach the buttons. As I said before, if you, for example, if you set the delayed button to shown only on the Wear, there will be just the reply button, but in the Wear there will be two of them, two. Then the last one is open on phone. It's come by default. If you click on the direct notification in the phone, there will be run the pending intent that we created in previous slides. So if you click this, you are like clicking the notification itself. If you click this, your phone will open the intent, will run the intent, which is set to two, to there. Here are some examples too. It's Google Plus's Wear app. Again, there is a message. If you swipe it up, you can see the full text. Then swipe the left, the plus one button, comment button, and open on the phone button. These are some input methods, input types for wearable devices. You can get input from Android Wear. It's maybe you can get input with voice. You can get voice comments from Wear, like this, the right now, the user telling the words, and the wearable device is getting them. But there will be loud on the environment, so the Wear cannot recognize your words, your said words. You can add some little buttons, the short words, for example, yes, no, maybe. So the user can choose these to make an action instead of speaking for it. The notifications are easy, as you see. There is nothing to do with anything different from the usual notifications. The real one is Android Wear apps. These are different apps, real apps for Android Wear. They are like usual Android apps, but less source. We have less source resource. We have a worse CPU, a worse RAM, so a little screen. So we have to take care of this. Yes, these are some Android Wear apps on the Google Play Store. For example, Hangouts, Maps, Pinterest. You can use this directly on your wearable device. But you have to connect your wearable device to your phone to use it. And the Google Play Store doesn't appear on the Wear, so you have to install them with your phone. If you install it with your phone, it's automatically paired with your wearable device. So these applications goes into your wearable device also. There is a chance with it because there are not so much applications on the Google Play Store about Android Wear, but it's growing day by day, so we can catch a trend with this by early. Here are some examples with Wear apps. Here's a calculator, a screen light application. It just sets screen's brightness to the maximum and looks like this. And this one, I think it has a great UI and UX for Android Wear, a weather application. So as you can see, the developer who developed it, I don't know, but has a great UI ability, UX ability. You can see everything you need on the phone. sorry for on the wear, they are these are very great applications. So what can what applications can we develop for wear? Is there any restrictions or how can I say? Yes, restrictions. It's cool. No, even if you can develop well, you can play Flappy Bird on your wearable device too. But as I said before, there are less RAM, worse CPU, and a smaller screen. So we must take care about this. Setting up, let's see how can we set the development environment. We just need Android Studio and the latest SDKs of Android and Android Wear, and an Android device also. We don't have wearable device, Android Wear device to start the development. It is just we can just use the emulator for it. Are there any mobile developer here? Android developer here? How many of you developed Android before? Cool. First of all, you must know some Android development to develop for Android Wear. It's not so different from the usual Android development. There are some differences. We will create an Android Wear emulator. Then we will install Android Wear app to our phone. It's on the Google Play Store. We can download it. Then we connect our phone to the computer with USB cable. We will make this forward port forwarding with this command on the terminal, and then we will run the Android Wear emulator and select pair with emulator from the Android Wear app. There is one important thing to care: every time that you connect your phone to your computer, you have to make the port forwarding again and again. This is the important thing we have to care. So it's done. We make our setting up. We didn't yet, but we will do now. So I want to make a little demo for this. Yes, it's here. So I'm creating a new project. I can name it jPrime demo. In here, we will make this application for phones and tablets, and also for wear. Here is. So I click next. I want to Android Studio that create the blank activities for me. Yes, here it's done. Here. Yes, it's done. As you can see, there are two modules. First one is for mobile, the second one is for wear. There are like two other projects, so with this one, we can make our applications for Android application for handset devices. With this one, we can develop our applications for wear. I will start with the emulator. So I think it's here. Yes. I've created before, but we can create again. I choose wear, square or round. We can create both of them. Yes, here it is. It's that easy. But there is an important thing to remind that we must use this one for build architecture. It may may make a problem with Macintosh's operating system. So here it is. I'm running this. Yes, here we can see it. It's loading. You can see there is no connection with any phone or tablet. This icon says that. So I'm opening the phone. The application, Android Wear application, looks like this. It's trying to connect the emulator, but it cannot because we didn't make the port forwarding yet. Here is the code. So yes, it's done. As you can see, it's connected. It's paired with my phone. Again, maybe you can see here writes the connected. So these are paired anymore. When my phone will take a notification, it will be appear on the wearable device, the wear emulator too. The setting is that easy. So we can go with some codes. I think I must mirror the screens. It will be easier. Yes. Okay. I'm opening my activity class. I will add a button to send the notification. When I click the button, I will send the notification to both phone and the wear. So actually, I can do it with here.
Can you zoom in?
Sorry?
Can you zoom in?
Okay. Is it okay? I can zoom more. Yes. It's not rendering. I don't know why. So yes, I have to give it an ID. Yes. And I have to give it a text. So yes, here we go. I'll write my Java codes. Here I'm setting up my button. Now I'm adding a click listener to this button to take the action. Okay, it's done. I'll create the notification and send the notification to phone and to wear here with there. So it can be wait here. Now I will create a notification just shown in the slides. So I will cheat now. Again, I'm creating two pending intents to make actions. Here are the imports. And setting the pending intents. It's okay. Creating the action, which will be only shown on the wearable device. It's okay. And the notification builder, where we build our notification. So yes, here with the builder pattern of notification compat class, I'm creating a builder with its icon, title with test, and its text is test message. And as I said before, it will extend the action just on the Android Wear. The action here is the reply button will not show on the phone, and so on. Yes, our notification manager has successfully created. And then I say that when the user clicked the notification button, sent the notification. Let's look this. Sorry. Yes, with the notification manager, I notify the device with the notification that we built it with our builder class. So let's give it a try. Here's the important thing. If you want your mobile application to run, you have to select this one, mobile, here. If you're developing the Wear app, you will choose the wear. So let's look at it. I think it's compiling. Yes, I select my phone. Yes, here is our application that we write here. If I click the button, it will send a notification. So here's the here too. The great sound of Samsung. it's shown on both in the phone and the wear too. Let's look at on the phone. Maybe you can see, maybe you cannot. There is a little notification, but there is no button on it. But here, in the Wear emulator, we can see the reply button, reply action here. And open on phone, here, and block app. This makes the application cannot send any notifications to a Wear device. Let's see what will be happen if I choose the reply button. It says okay and to open my dialer app from my phone. If I choose the open on phone action here, it will do the notification click on the phone, so the notification will hide from both on Wear and the phone itself. And also, if you again send a notification and you delete from the phone, it will be deleted on the Wear too. But not vice versa. If you dismiss it from your Wear, it still looks on your phone. This is the notification way, just using with notification to make your existing app Android Wear compatible. As you can see, it's very easy. You can make it in 5 minutes or less. But we should look about the real Wear apps too. I won't go in detail with this because it's a very huge thing to talk about in a little time. So let's look at this. The Wear module, we can inspect it. It has a manifest just like the usual Android app has. It has Java codes, it has activities like, again, in the usual phone apps. It also has resources, it has layout, but there is a difference, a little difference with the usual Android app. Here it is the main activities layout file. There it says if our watch has rectangle layout, use rect activity main. If our wearable device has a round layout, use the layout which is round activity main. So let's look at with this. The rectangle one, it says here is the, it's a Wear, and we can look at this. Yes. It looks, it will look like this on the wearable device. So the other one, the round one is, let's look at it with this. Yes, it will look like this. Again, its code is like this. Its text view is on the center of the screen. I think we can make this too, like this. Okay. Yes, here it is. So if you run this app on your wearable device, if your Wear is Android Wear device is a square, you will see this Hello Square World. But if it is a round one, you will see like this Hello Round World text on it. Let's give it a try. The phone must be connected on the Wear for its run. Yes, you can see it says Hello Round World. Let's try with the rectangle one. Yes. Setting up. It's again not connected. Maybe I must make the port forwarding again. And yes, it's connected. So I'm running it again. So yes, it writes Hello Square World here. This is the thing that we must care about it, because the square one and the round one has different layout styles. For example, here are the areas that we can use in the square one, but if it is a round one, we can't use here, so these fields. So we must take care about this. We have to make our Android Wear apps for both round and the Wear ones, rectangle ones. So this is a little introduction for Android Wear. Thank you very much. Thank you to the, again, Bulgarian Jack for inviting me and making the great conference here. I'm very happy to be here. So you can keep in touch with me with Twitter and with my mail. I will try to answer your all questions as I can. So do you have any questions, or we can go to the directed to drink beers. I think no. Okay, thank you again.